the heart and the pericardium. The surface anatomy of heart is drawn between four points forming four borders of the heart. The upper border is slightly oblique line drawn between the lower border of the second left costal cartilage, 1.5 centimeters from the sternal margin, to the upper border of the third right costal cartilage, 1.5 centimeters from the sternal margin also. Right border is slightly convex line between the right end of the upper border to the right sixth costal cartilage, also 1.5 centimeters from the sternal margin. The lower border nearly horizontal line between the lower end of the right border and the fifth left intercostal space, 3.5 inches or 9 centimeters from the midline. It is coincident with the apex of the heart. The left border is an oblique line between the point of the apex to the left end of the upper border. This is the upper border of the heart here, from the second to third, from the third to sixth, then left to fifth intercostal space, 3.5 inches from the midline. This is coincident with the apex of the heart. Surface anatomy of the valves of the heart. The valves of the heart, number one, pulmonary valve at the third costal cartilage behind the left margin of the sternum. Aortic valve at the third intercostal space behind the left margin of the sternum also. Mitral valve at the fourth costal cartilage behind the left margin of the sternum. But the tricuspid valve at the fourth intercostal space at the middle of the sternum. Atrioventricular groove or coronary groove between the third left costal cartilage to the sternal end of the sixth right costal cartilage. This is the valve, third intercostal space, then the fourth and the intercostal space. This is the areas of auscultation of the heart and the thoracic wall. This is the aortic valve in the right second intercostal space, pulmonary valve in the left second, then the mitral valve in the fifth intercostal space, coincident with the apex of the heart, and this is tricuspid valve here at the lower part of the sternum. The pericardium is formed by fibrous and serous membranes which surrounds the heart and the proximal parts of great vessels attached to the heart. The pericardium is formed by fibrous pericardium and the serous pericardium, which lines the fibrous pericardium. The fibrous is tough connective tissue forming the outer layer that defines the boundaries of the middle mediastinum. Serous pericardium is a thin membrane that consists of two parts. Parietal layer lines the inner surface of the fibrous pericardium, and visceral layer adheres to the heart and forms outer covering of the heart. Sometimes it is called epicardium. This is the heart covered by pericardium, and this after removal of the pericardium. The outer is the fibrous, then lined by inner layer of the serous pericardium. Relation of the fibrous pericardium anteriorly, pleura and the lungs of both sides. Upper and the lower sternopericardial ligaments connecting the fibrous pericardium to the back of the body of the sternum. Cardiac notch of the left lung is related to the pericardium, so the pericardium comes in direct contact with the thoracic wall, so it is called the bare area of the pericardium. Posteriorly related to descending aorta and the esophagus. At each side, phrenic nerves and pericardiaco-phrenic arteries. Mediastinal surface of the pleura and the lungs. Inferiorly, central tendon of the diaphragm. This is the fibrous pericardium occupying the middle mediastinum. Sinuses of the pericardium. There are two sinuses related to the serous pericardium. Transverse sinus of the pericardium, bounded anteriorly by pulmonary trunk and ascending aorta. and the posteriorly it is bounded by lower part of the superior vena cava. This is the transverse sinus, the anteriorly ascending aorta and pulmonary trunk, posteriorly the lower part of the superior vena cava. Oblique sinus of the pericardium. This is the oblique sinus bounded by anteriorly by the back of the left atrium, posteriorly by fibrous pericardium, separating the sinus from the esophagus and descending aorta. At the side, there is pulmonary veins. Superiorly, reflection of the visceral pericardium from the back of the left atrium to the fibrous pericardium. Inferiorly, it is continuous with the rest of the pericardial cavity. Arterial and nerve supply of the pericardium. Arterial supply comes from the pericardiacophrenic artery, which is a branch from the internal mammary. Branches from musculophrenic artery also arises as a branch from internal mammary or internal thoracic. Branches from the internal mammary directly, then branches from the descending aorta. Nerve supply, phrenic nerves, and autonomic branches from both vagi and the sympathetic trunks. This is the arterial supply through the internal mammary, and this is nerve supply, phrenic, and autonomic nerves.